gates of hell. The gates of hell are various places on the surface of the world that have acquired a legendary reputation for being entrances to the underworld. Often they are found in regions of unusual geological activity, particularly volcanic areas, or sometimes at lakes, caves, or mountains. Legends from both ancient Greece and Rome record stories of mortals who entered or were abducted into the netherworld through such gates. Aeneas visited the underworld, entering through a cave at the edge of Lake Avernus on the Bay of Naples. Hercules entered the underworld from this same spot. In the middle of the Roman Forum is another entrance, Lacus Curtius, where according to legend, a Roman soldier named Curtius bravely rode his horse into the entrance in a successful effort to close it, although both he and his horse perished in the deed. Orpheus traveled to the Greek underworld in search of Eurydice by entering a cave at Taenarum, or Cape Taenarum, on the southern tip of the Peloponnese. Into the medieval period, Mount Etna on Sicily was considered to be an entryway to hell. The gates of hell were commonly depicted as jaws forming the hellmouth, which was simultaneously the entrance to hell and the mouth of a huge monster. August Rodin was commissioned to make a pair of bronze doors to symbolize the gates of hell. He received the commission on August 20, 1880, for a new art museum in Paris to exhibit at the 1889 Exposition Universelle, which ultimately did not open. However, in 1900, some of them were part of his first solo exhibition in Paris. Is the gates of hell still burning? The Davisa crater, more commonly known as the Daughter Hell, still burns today, a surreal feature in an otherwise barren landscape. Details on the origin of the sinkhole are sketchy. But the story goes that Soviet scientists set it on fire to burn off noxious gases after the ground under a drilling rig gave way. What are the gates of hell called? Though technically called the Davisa gas crater, locals know the crater as the gates of hell. Its fiery glow can be seen for miles around. Deadvlei. Deadvlei is a white clay pan located near the more famous salt pan of Sossusvlei inside the Namib-Naukluft Park in Namibia. Also written Deadvlei or Deadvlei, its name means dead marsh from English dead and Afrikaansvlei, a lake or marsh in a valley between the dunes. The pan also is referred to as Deadvlei, which is the presumably original, fully Afrikaans name. There are many references to the site on the internet, its name often being translated erroneously in terms such as Dead Valley. Of Lei is not a valley, which in Afrikaans is valley, nor is the site a valley. The pan is a desiccated valley. Deadvlei has been claimed to be surrounded by the highest sand dunes in the world. the highest reaching 300 to 400 meters, 350 meters on average, named Big Daddy, or Crazy Dune, which rests on a sandstone terrace. The clay pan was formed after rainfall when that Sorchab River flooded, creating temporary shallow pools where the abundance of water allowed camel thorn trees to grow. When the climate changed, drought hit the area and sand dunes encroached on the pan, which blocked the river from the area. The trees died as there no longer was enough water to survive. There are some species of plants remaining, such as Sossusvlei and clumps of Nera, adapted to surviving off the morning mist and very rare rainfall. The remaining skeletons of the trees, which are believed to have died 600,700 years ago, cap 1340 to 1430, are now black because the intense sun has scorched them. Though not petrified, the wood does not decompose because it is so dry. How old are the trees in Deadvlei? The trees are estimated to be approximately 900 years old. However, they have not decomposed due to the dry climate. Deadvlei is a paradise for photographers, as the contrast between the pitch black trees and bleached white pans and the rusty red dunes and deep blue sky make for incredible images. How do I get to Deadvlei? If you're keen to visit Deadvlei, you'll need follow the paved road from Sesrim to the 2WD car park. Then jump aboard the National Park's shuttle for a 4-kilometer drive to the hike starting point. For Hidden Valley, the hike commences from the 2WD car park. How safe is Namibia? Namibia is, for the most part, a safe country to visit. Namibia is, for the most part, a safe country to visit. Crime is a serious issue in Namibia's capital, Windhoek, and other areas throughout Namibia.